Never would have made it. Never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me, and I can say, never would have made it.
Let me just give God a little hand praise.
Never could have made it without
you.
I would have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me, and I can say, I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over all you brought me through, I can see that you were the one I held on to, and I never,
never would have made it.
Oh, I never could have made it.
How many of you know the devil, if you're a child of the King, the devil don't like you?
Amen.
Period.
Amen.
Hmm? Understanding our hurts and feelings. Sometimes we get hurt. Sometimes our feelings are hurt. And we have to understand our hurts and our feelings. Battle of life and ministry. Sometimes, you know, haven't you ever, if you're not careful, ministry can consume you. But you have to have a balance. Because I can't be all ministry and not family.
Amen.
Because my first ministry is my family.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Amen.
That's my first ministry. I could not be here. I could not be in South Africa if my wife was saying, I don't want you to go.
Yeah.
Amen. Huh?
Amen.
But thank God he gave me a wife that cooperates with a man that's called to the ministry and is always gone. And she cooperates with that. I don't know how she does it, but God equipped her to do it. How to use our armor and fruits of the Spirit in restoring your joy and finishing your course. Understanding your calling. Everyone has something deep down within that God has placed in them. It sets deep in the very heart of the soul. It calls out to you. Some have been given talents in music, huh? Teaching, sports, a call to do or get things done, a career, doctor, nurse, police, officer, fireman, or ministry. When we say ministry, this concerns you. God has put whatever has been taken up your thoughts concerning the kingdom of God. For example,
we are that light in the dark place. Hmm? And understand something when you know, in the scripture they said that God divided the night from the day.
Yep.
Did he or did he not?
Yes, he did.
But he even gave night a light.
That's right, he sure did.
Come on here, somebody.
Amen.
Night even has a light. So night ain't totally dark.
Right.
Because it gave us the moon. That gets the light from the sun. And we are the light in the dark.
Amen.
And our light comes from
the sun.
Come on, talk to me, somebody. You might have to edit that one. I felt like preaching for a minute.
afternoon, everyone. We're getting ready to get started with the blessing of the bites, feet, body, and muscle. I am the pastor of the newly formed Open Arms International Church. This is the place where love lives. Our supporting scripture is Matthew chapter 11 and verse 28. Come unto me, all ye that are labored and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. We are coming to this area to bring the love of God to everyone that we come in contact with. Remember, this is the place where love lives.
A topic this morning I would like to take. You can't find me.
All right.
Amen.
Okay. Look at your neighbor and say, ha ha. You can't find me.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. He that dwelleth in the secret. There's something about a secret. I saw a shirt that a young man had on at my job, and it said, three can keep a secret if two of them are dead. Something about a secret. Sometimes people have a hard time keeping a secret.
Yeah.
Have you ever told someone something personal? Because you just had to talk to somebody. And you revealed your secret. And you thought it was safe with them. And as you were walking along your way, you found that your business was all over the street and everywhere, all through the plant, all in the city, all at City Hall, all in the mall. Everybody knew your business that you thought was a secret because you revealed it to someone that you trusted. The Bible says a talebearer revealeth secrets.
Yes.
But he that is of a faithful spirit concealeth the matter. They keep it confidential. Unfortunately, we go through things, as I said, and we have no answers. We don't know what to do with it. And the Bible tells us to lean not to our own understanding, because we're not going to understand everything in this life.
Yes, sir.
Some answers are not on this earth, but some answers are in heaven, and God's just waiting for us to get there so he can give us some of the answers that we have been asking on the earth. But some answers are in heaven. Come on here, somebody. My God, my God, my God. And so it said, if it had not been for the Lord on my side. There was times in our lives when we have been through things where we felt like we were going to lose our minds.
Yes.
Has anybody ever been there? I have been there where I've been in situations where it felt like, Lord, I am going to lose my mind. I don't know how I'm going to make it through this thing. I don't know which way to turn. I don't know what to do. And I'm confused. And I feel like I'm going to lose my mind. And when you look back over your life and you realize that God brought you through it, you can say, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I would not have made it. I would not have kept my mind up. But he said, I will keep you in perfect peace if you just keep your mind stayed on me. Come on here, somebody. I feel like understand this. He didn't say he will keep you in peace. He said he'll keep you in perfect.
constantly grieving. Because God is love.
This is the place
it's running?
Yes, sir.
Pastor Clark, let me tell you something. Break the music down just a little bit, because this is a word from the heavens concerning Pastor Clark. These are my witnesses right here. All the hell that Pastor Clark and his wife went through to get to this point, God is a rewarder of them that diligently seek. Now pray with me this morning. That diligently seek him. Everything that has happened in your life, Pastor Clark, was all a setup for the elevation that God is raising you
Hallelujah.
To. You weren't just a chaplain in the UAW. You weren't just a chaplain in the prison ministry. You weren't just a chaplain with the IPFCA. You are a chaplain for God. That means that you are a mediator between God and his people. I don't care if it's at the workplace. I don't care if it's at the prison. I don't care if it's at the street corner. I don't care if it's at the homeless shelter. God is setting you up for a time like this, that you will be a pastor to the mystic.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Look at somebody and tell them it's on now.
It's on now. It's on now.
Pastor Clark, when you see this, look at your wife and say it's on now. Syracuse, and I'm telling it, I don't care. I ain't scared of nobody, but when I leave here, I'm going home. One thing that the people in Syracuse are scared of, somebody is coming to tell the truth. It's too much compromising going on, but God is raising up open arms right now. Just lean back and roll. Pastor Clark, Open Arms Church. It didn't say Open Arms Baptist. It didn't say Open Arms Church of God in Christ. It didn't say Open Arms Apostolic. It says Open Arms.
That's right.
That means that the only denomination we need to deal with is God. Pastor Clark, this is just the beginning of greatness. Because watch this, and I'm done. Those same people that hating on you right now is the same ones that's gonna push you in your building.
Sing it one more time. All I need is it one more time. Everybody say with me.
I got purpose.
Yes, Lord.
Just here taking up space, but my space is with purpose.
Yes,
my presence is for a reason.
Yes,
I'm not just like a picture hanging on the wall. Come on here, somebody.
Yes,
but I have purpose, and purpose must move.
Yes, Lord.
Where there is the vision, the people perish.
Now understand this in your vision. Sometimes you'll have a vision and you can't share your vision with everybody.
Amen. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
When we started Open Arms, I started it quietly. Some people didn't even know that we were starting it.
No.
I had people call me. I heard you were starting a church, but I told them, no. Are you starting a church? Said first service of 2 weeks. Excuse me, I said our first service is in 2 weeks. You can't always release your vision and dreams to everyone. Because you got dream stealers and vision blockers. Oh my God, my God. So you can't let them know everything you do. See, what you gotta do is you gotta go on and do what God called you to do. And by the time they recognize what you're doing, it's too late. It's too late. Well, we didn't know about that one. Now you know. Don't you do? Come on here, somebody.
Right.
Hallelujah. If that release your vision.
That's right. Yes, Lord. That's right. Because everybody is not on your side.
That's right.
Are you hearing me? Right. Some people smile in your back too. Can I go OJ's on you? All the time they want to take your place. Your backstab. Can I stand like this? Come on here, somebody wants to stab you in your back. Smile in your face. Say, I'm on your side. And the minute they turn your back and talking about you, and they plotting and they're scheming against you. That's why sometimes you just gotta keep your mouth. I remember Bishop Jones said to me, Jesus was done with silence, and he opened it down his mouth, keep your mouth shut, because silence can't be repeated. Look at your neighbor and say, silence can't be repeated.
That's right.
You don't give them nothing to say, they ain't got nothing to say. If they say something, it's going to be a lie. Come on, talk.
That's right.
But they don't know what to say. Come on, hear somebody.
I made it. Is there anybody in this house other than me that could
to open up International Ministry? Come on! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Come on, give God a praise! Give God a praise!
Oh, I wish I had some help here. I wish I had just two or three people that would just declare it. Never would have made it.
Never could have made it.
Never could have made it.
Never could have made it.
I just love to encourage myself.